There, Molly, as in the movie, we find out she's not allowed to come to Canada. Aaron was very helpful in getting her a 48-hour pass to come to the premiere last night. But so when we were on set, we filmed the movie in Toronto. She couldn't come. I had her on text messages, and I could call her anytime, and she was very open and available. But actually, I think at the end of the day, it's probably for me more helpful for her not to be on set, because I had to believe when I was acting the part that I was Molly, and to see her there is always a reminder of like, oh yeah, or how is she holding her hand, and I'm not doing that, or it's a reminder that I'm not playing that character. As an actor, when you're playing anyone, alive or dead, you have to do whatever you can to study them, to their mannerisms, their voice, the look, as much as you can. But then also, too, you have to create your interpretation of that. And that's what separates, I guess, biopics and films from documentaries. And so for me to have her there, I think would have been very distracting, especially for my confidence.
I wasn't going to ask Jessica to play Molly in front of Molly. And so even scenes, like as Jessica said, she is, because she pled guilty to a federal crime in the U.S., she is not allowed, she's not welcome in Canada. But the scenes that we shot in Jessica's scene with, Molly's scene with her father, Jessica and Kevin, on the park bench at the end. Shot that in Central Park in New York. I would never have asked Jessica to do that scene in front of Molly. That would have been unfair. And I thought if Molly wants to come to the set, she can watch maybe, you know, the 13-year-old version of her ski or something, and the two of them can have fun skiing. As it happened, all Molly, I'll tell you what Molly did do. She sent a whole bunch of cookies to the editors that I just named with a note saying, there's more where this came from if you cut my brother out of the movie.